今是华尔街时刻，我是米少于超，现在位于纽约纳斯达克教育大厅，为您带来本周的市场分析。那么看到近日美国和中国之间的贸易局势的紧张似乎是正在缓和，那么今天的股市也有小幅的反弹，但受到全球关注的一位投资者啊，是仍然极为担心这个贸易战的可能性。他就是刚刚到访中国的对冲基金 Bridgewater Associates 的亿万富翁创始人 Ray Dalio。 那么这周呢， Dalio 说到他对特朗普总统对中国的这个敌对立场是越来越感到紧张了。我被迫关注特朗普总统将会领导我们走向何方，他的真正目标又是什么。达里奥本周在一篇名为 More on Trade and Other Words 的 LinkedIn 的文章中写道，现在我认为任何人，包括一些离川普总统最近的人，都不清楚他的战略目标究竟是什么。我们应该思考除了贸易战之外的其他可能性。中国我们知道是美国国债的最大持有者，如果中国开始销售这些债券，那么人们就会怀疑美国经济的复苏能持续多久，这也可能会推高利率。那么现在市场上有人担心，如果中国大量的出售美国的资产，可能会使美国的利率上升，对整个世界都会产生一个影响。那么当下达里奥和华尔街的一些分析师均担心这一点，但是又同时表示这个可能性当下来看较小。本周除美股市场以外，周一美元对其他发达市场和新兴市场货币出现了一个大幅的反转，而大宗商品的价格是温和复苏。进入本周的周二后，英镑和欧元在周一的走势和涨势中是继续看涨，而美元指数很可能在未来几天至几周内走弱，因为 DXY 看起来是处于一个季节性的疲软期，那么经过上周晚些时候的短暂调整后再次转跌是负，目前是看来符合四月份的美元的一个季节性趋势。谷物价格是在大幅的上涨，而 WTI 原油反弹是在至一个关键的支撑位，黄金也是成功的推高至了1340点以上。目前华尔街是长期看涨大宗商品市场。那么下面我们来连线芝加哥 CME 分析师，来谈谈中美商谈和大宗商品市场的本周行情。
Traders on the streets said the Chinese President Xi Jinping's promises to open sectors from banking to auto manufacturers were unrelated to the U.S. trade complaints and not intended as a response. So from his comments and the current situation, what are your thoughts on the China's moves?
I certainly think anything's a possibility, especially when you're talking about a markets that are growing as fast as they're in China, markets that would really benefit each other if we do see connectivity. So right now, I'm not going to say it's going to happen tomorrow or maybe the next day, but I think in the long run, it benefits the globalization of everything else when you're talking about the internet sales. It certainly makes sense to start connecting some of these global exchanges.At the same level to open the doors and lower those barriers to entry so that all participants can trade all markets.
I actually really liked President Xi's comments on the auto industry, very sincere and actually makes a lot of sense. I mean, the headlines we see in America are very skewed, and I do believe that China sees U.S. cars and imports as a legitimate import. It's very complicated given the different tariffs that are in place and the currency risk and the parts, et cetera, et cetera. So I do think his comments were very thought out. And after people digest them, they'll realize that China is a constructive and good trade partner.
Oil prices jumped to 3-year high after Trump warns Russia missiles will be coming Syria. How much upside room oil prices can reach?
Well, everything seems to be going right with oil. Demand is very strong. We have all of a sudden geopolitics that matter. OPEC's being compliant. And the inventories, although they were up yesterday, they've been down more than a consensus for the past 3 to 4 weeks. So that said, I do see WTI could definitely breach that $70 a barrel mark. But getting to that point, isn't going to be a straight line.
One of the more interesting developments in the last few days concerns the sudden surge in energy, which saw ETFs like XLE, OIH, and XOP all make meaningful short-term breakouts after nearly 2 months of sideways consolidation, where energy stocks had all but ignored the move in WTI crude. The ability in WTI to bottom out late last week and its strong rebound helped XLE hit new weekly highs, and quite a few stocks showed meaningful strength. So, based on your comments, and next, then for the good market, good we know is benefiting from the risk of sentiment, and people are trying to hedge against the worst-case scenarios. So, what is the most possible worst-case scenarios from your point of view, and what is your prediction on gold trend in the near term?
Yeah, gold's been a fascinating trade, and it did bounce back today quite healthily. It just seems like the narrative is not whether central banks are buying or selling, whether supply and demand is good or bad. It's really all on risk on, risk off. And so for the near term, gold's going to continue to trade in a very, very narrow but volatile trading range.
The RMB, the yuan, both onshore and offshore was little changed. Some traders had expected the yuan to be stuck in narrow ranges around 6.3 per dollar. What is your outlook on it?
I am very optimistic on the currency. I do believe that a lot of the headline risk will start to fade. I do believe that even though credit conditions are tightening a little bit in China, I think they're plateauing from a very high level. Also believe that industry sector will continue to rev up. We just came off, you know, a holiday, and it seems like a time when you know, the ports are full. But I do think in the second quarter, especially, we'll see a good bounce back on the currency.
好的，感谢您收看本期的金石华人时刻，我们下期再会。